Hello everyone, I'm Charles. Welcome to Graphic Design Quicksters. In today's episode, we'll be coloring the stripes of a zebra, red, green, and blue. Overall, this is what we'll achieve. We will be coloring the black stripes of the zebra, red, green, and blue alternately, and later fuse them with the colors of the zebra using some blend mode and some luminance adjustment. Let us turn on our color layer. First step is to limit the red, green, and blue to the black stripes. We will do that by creating a mask. Let us start by creating a selection using the color range. Press D to make sure you have the default foreground and background colors, because color range always select the foreground color by default. Let us hide our color layer. Click on the background layer. Go to select. Color range. Drag the fuzziness to the highest value, that is 200. That will select all the blacks. Click OK. Let us show our color layer. Click on the color layer to make it active. Go to the bottom of the layers panel. Click on add layer mask icon. Let me zoom in. You can see some of the colors were masked away. Let us work on the mask. Alt click on the adjustment layer thumbnail so that we can inspect the adjustment layer separately from the image. Anything that is white here in the original image is black. Let us enhance the contrast using levels. Go to image, adjustment. Levels, drag towards the left and straight all the whites are pure white. Land on 80, all our whites are pure white. You don't need to adjust the black point since our non-whites are well protected. Alt click again on the layer mask thumbnail to reveal the image. And then we have well masked colors. Let me zoom out. The next step is to fuse the RGB colors naturally with the zebra colors. For that, we use blending modes. At this point, you can choose whichever blend mode works for you. If the image was bright enough, we could use Multiply, and that's what Multiply gives us. If the image was dark enough, we could use Screen. That is what Screen gives us. In this case, let's go with Soft Right. To add to the natural blend, let us extrude some luminous levels. Double click on an empty area on the right of the color layer. That will give us the layer style dialog box. Go to this underline layer bar. Drag the white bar to the left. What it does, it passes through the brightness of the underlying layer. At this point, we've gone too far. Let us drag bar to around 150. That gives us some harsh transition. Hold Alt and drag the white bar to the left to split it. Drag it to around 180. Drag the other half to the left to around 70. That gives us some natural transition. Between 0 and 70, the luminous levels of the underlying layers are blocked. Between 70 and 150, we have a gradual transition. And between 70 and 180, the luminous level of the underlying layers shows through. Click OK. Let me press F a couple of times to fill the window with the image. And that's how you color any dark image, not necessarily a zebra. That's it for today. Like, share, and consider subscribing to our channel so that you don't miss out on our next episode.